What's up, everyone? Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to another detail. It's your boy JC reporting for another nasty detail, and this is a 2004 Hyundai Sonata, and it's in for an interior detail. But let me tell you guys, this is the dirtiest and nastiest detail that I've ever done. So I'm really excited how long it's gonna take and how this car can look when it's all clean. But before starting with it, make sure to subscribe to the channel, click on the notification bell if you don't wanna miss any future videos like this. And now, let's get detailing. All right, now, and just by watching the previews, you guys already know I have to take the seats out so I can get them in the best shape possible, and also giving me more space to completely clean this interior, which is a complete disaster. Okay, now, and just for those of you wondering, or if you want to try this yourself and take the seats out, make sure you don't have power, meaning disconnect the negative from your battery before disconnecting the seats. And then whenever you're done cleaning, make sure to connect the seats before connecting your battery again, so you don't end up having an airbag light. Alright, and now for the vacuuming process, I use a rigid 4-gallon portable vacuum, which I have the link in the description down below, just in case you guys are interested, as any of the products that you guys see me use in this video. Right now, and as a request of some of you guys, I've left the real time and sound out some of the clips of the vacuuming process.
Okay, now I want to give you guys a quick little background story of how I got to detail this car. And it's because it's actually from someone that I know, and I was helping him get some stuff of this car. And when I saw it, I just couldn't walk away from it. So I offered him if he would let me detail it for free, because he's a really nice guy. And I just wanted to challenge myself and see how clean I could get this car, because he said it's been 16 years without a wash or touched anything from the interior. So that gave me a lot of inspiration to see how I could transform this vehicle. Alrighty, now since I had the seats out, I went ahead and worked on them first so I can have them ready and dry for whenever I was done with this detail. Alrighty, now just from the first pass, you guys can see a lot of difference, but there's still a lot more to do, and I only show the first two passes here because it just took a long time to get these seats clean, which in total I believe I did about 5 passes until I was satisfied with the results. I
times we're not ourselves. There's no one I can turn to. And I know all the feelings that we shared are in the past. And I know your relationships are never meant to last. And I'll take some time, but I'll be alright. We're moving on, we're moving on. I know times are tough, but I've had enough. We're moving on, we're moving on, we're moving on.
Alrighty, now just for those of you wondering, I was using super clean diluted 10:1 because I just knew it was gonna be a little harder to take this off, and because it's been sitting there for a lot of time without being cleaned, so I just didn't want to waste any time and went ahead with the dilution of 10:1. Alrighty, now all you guys are about to see is the before and after, or just going two passes in, but of course I did went ahead and did more passes until I was satisfied with the results. Alrighty, now all done with the two seats, I went ahead and worked on the front panels as there is a lot of buttons and I like to go ahead and use the detailing brush so I can get into all those cracks and crevices. All right, and now for this section, I went ahead and used the steamer so I can loosen up all that grime and then pick it up with a microfiber towel or pick up as much as I can. And then for the last step, use the detailing brush so I can get into those small cracks and crevices where the microfiber towel or the steamer can get in. Alright, and now to clean this cloth section of the door, I went ahead and used my carpet solution, a little help of this small drill brush attachment and the extractor to ensure not to leave any water or solution in these panels. Alright, and now moving on with the plastic trims, I went ahead and used the steamer because it was just all full with grime and there was not easier way or faster way to do this but with the steamer, as it gets everything off the panels with only one pass and then pick up everything with the microfiber towel. And of course I always like going back with the detailing brush to get into all the crevices. Okay, now, and if you guys been watching my videos for a little while, you know I like to use my color lock brush for the steering wheels, but on this one I just couldn't do it with that one, so I had to use the steamer because this steering wheel was just really nasty, and I believe this is the nastiest one we've done in the channel. But I was able to get everything off with the steamer with a few passes and a microfiber towel. Alrighty, now all done with the cleaning, it's now time to extract all the carpets, and I use the same dilution as I did with the seats. Taking over. I like that one. And if you guys are enjoying this video so far, please don't forget to smash the like button. Alright, and now to protect and revive this interior, I'm using 303 Aerospace UV Protectant. Alright, now we've reached the end of today's video, and if you guys enjoyed it, make sure to smash the like button, leave a comment down below, and show some love and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys on the next one.